As we get closer to the Rosh Chodesh, Rosh Chodesh Av, which begins the 9 days, the halachot begin to become a little bit more stringent. Halacha says as follows: אף על פי שיש נוהגים להחמיר על עצמם שלא לאכול בשר, שלא לשתות יין, החל מליל יום זין בתמוז עד אחר תשעה באב.
There is a custom out there of people that do not eat meat or drink wine starting from Yom Zayin B'Tammuz,
which is 2 weeks ago.
Starting from the fast, the first fast of Yom Zayin B'Tammuz, all the way till after Tisha B'Av, they don't have no meat, they don't have any wine. It says there are people that have this custom.
However, מכל מקום המנהג הפשוט,
בירושלים, בארץ ישראל, and most קהילות, is not like this.
Most of the Kehilot
did not accept upon themselves starting from Shema Asar to Tammuz,
as this would be too difficult
for most people not to have meat, not to have chicken for 3 weeks straight would be a very difficult task,
and therefore this was not acceptable
by most people as the custom. Rather, Yehidim,
only specific people
that wanted to be with Abel and they took upon themselves to be stringent, to be Mahmir, they did that.
So what do we do?
The regular people, Hamon Am, the regular people, what do we do?
So there's a machloket ben Sfaradim Ashkenazim
when it starts. Lefi HaSfaradim, it's the day after Rosh Chodesh Av. That would be, this year, Rosh Chodesh falls out on Friday.
So the day after would be starting from Shabbat,
but Shabbat we don't follow this. So Shabbat, a person is allowed to eat meat.
So this year would come out starting from Motzei Shabbat Sunday.
That's it, no more meat. Mahmid, we don't eat meat all the way from this week, Saturday night, Sunday, all the way till after Tisha B'Av is over, which this year immediately after Tisha B'Av is already the 10th. So yeah, a person could eat. Okay, according to the Syrians anyways, according to the Shamis, they were allowed to eat. They had the manhag that they did eat anyways. But again, so starting from the day after Rosh Chodesh is when this Isur comes about. But Ashkenazim, they machmir even on Rosh Chodesh itself, so they wouldn't eat meat even on Friday. But by us, this week Friday, those that eat regular meat as a Friday meal, and that's the custom of many, many Syrian Shami homes. So in there, and in this case, this week, one would be allowed to eat and taste the food, no problem. It's not asur whatsoever. You could have the kibbeh, no issues. However, the following Friday, next week Friday, not this week, Rosh Chodesh, the week afterwards, which is the day, 2 days before Tisha B'Av, that would be under the 9 days. That would be the isur, and therefore one would not be allowed to partake in any of the food that they have prepared on Friday for Shabbat. One would have to wait till Shabbat. Again, we're going to learn the halakha that in regards to tasting the food of Shabbat, the pasuk says, "To'ameh ha'im zachu." One is allowed to taste the food of Shabbat if it's just a taste, not to have a whole meal. If a guy is tasting to see, to make sure that the food is good and it has the right, you know, everything is good, then the halakha is one is allowed to taste even next week Friday, not only this Friday. This week you're allowed to have regular. You can eat a regular meal. However, next Friday, one would not be allowed to eat any kind of meat during the week, starting from Sunday all the way till the end of the week. If a person wants to taste food of Shabbat on Friday the following week, that would be allowed, and there would be no issue.